الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is Allah's true slave and messenger. So often we hear about the term Israeliyat, and this is something which the people of Hadith, the scholars of Hadith, criticized concerning some of the narrations that came in the books of Tafsir, and also some which also came into the books of Hadith. This word which we often hear may be misunderstood by many, or even the meaning of it may be understood. Al-Israiliyat is a plural of Israeliyah, and this is related to Ya'qub alayhi salam. And Ya'qub is Israel. Ya'qub, Jacob is Israel, is Israel. And then there is a point of benefit here. Now, it seems that Ya'qub had two names. This is what Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah mentioned, that he said that there is no other prophet other than our prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who carried more than one name, except Ya'qub, except Jacob. This saying of Ibn al-Jawzi was also checked by other scholars who said that there are other prophets who may have more than one name, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But the point here, this is the Israeliyat, this is a plural of Israeliya in reference to Israel, and that is Ya'qub alayhi salam. Now, the term Israel, is composed of two parts. Some people said half of it is Arabic and half of it is Hebrew. The first one, according to this saying, Isra, comes from Isra, and this is the migration or going. And Il in Hebrew, it means Allah Azza wa Jal. And they say that Jacob alayhi salam migrated, and that's why he was called Israel, meaning the one migrating to Allah. This is one saying. The second saying is that the whole world is Hebrew, which may have some Arabic in it, and they say that Isra means the slave. Isra means the slave, and Il means Allah. So Israel would mean Abdullah, the slave of Allah. Now, terminology, with respect to terminology, the Israeliyat, the term Israeliyat, refers to the news whose origin is from Jewish sources. Then it expanded to include all that which is mentioned in the books of Tafsir or in the biographies without any origin to trace it to, and which are mostly focused on insulting the prophets or insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or in superstitious matters. So this is the term Israeliyat as to what it means and what it may cover. Now, we said that in the first part of the definition, that it relates to all that, all the news, the origin of which is Jewish in nature, then comes the question, how did these things reach the book of Tafsir and the books of Hadith? Many reasons. Number one, a group of the Jews lived in the Arabian Peninsula. And we know that mixing and interaction in works and travel and in social affairs and so forth, there will be exchange of cultural things and information. So people will take from each other. And this is one of the main reasons behind the introduction of these Israelites into the books of Tafsir and otherwise. Second, the arrival of Jews coming to the Arabian Peninsula for trade. And this is close to the first reason. The only difference is that these people came as, quote, visitors for business. And with respect to the first group, they were residents with Muslims in the area. The third reason is the migration of some Muslims to their lands in the greater Syria area, Palestine included, seeking sustenance and also for trade or in wars. And this also brought interaction and therefore exchange of news and information. And with time these things became settled to the degree that some people took them for granted. Fourth reason, the acceptance of some of the Jewish scholars, the acceptance by some of the Jewish scholars of Islam and their entrance into Islam. And this had a profound impact in carrying some of this information. And it is obvious that when the alim speaks, it's different from the common person. The influence of his works or the influence of his speech is like quote-unquote proof in general. Fifth reason is people's tendency to give ear to that which is strange and extraordinary and so forth. And this is obvious when you see someone or you hear someone speaking things of this nature, you find people giving ears, listening attentively, not even trying to miss a word. This is as to the reason for their introduction into the books of Tafsir and also into the books of Hadith. And the Israelites are also divided. Like Hadith, they are divided into authentic and weak in terms of the correctness of the chain of narrations. So we have authentic Israelites and weak Israelites. This is in general. Otherwise, there are clear ones that are false, and there are of a lesser degree. This is like the condition of the hadith, which is weak. There are weak narrations that are weaker than others. As an example on the weak, or an example on authentic narrations from the Israelites, is that which is mentioned by Ibn Kathir in his Tafsir, and it is from the way of Ibn Jarir, reporting from Ata bin Yasar, rahimahullah, who said that I met Abdullah bin Amr, and I said, tell me about the description of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Surah. He said, of course, wallahi innahu lamawsoof, by Allah he is described in the Surah, just like his description in the Quran. And then he gave the description of him in the Torah, which goes as follows. Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu, O Prophet of Allah, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira. We have sent you as a witness and giver of glad tidings and a warner. Anta abdi wa rasuli. You are my slave and messenger. اسمك المتوكل. Your name is the متوكل, meaning the one who depends upon Allah. ليس بفضل ولا غليظ. You are neither harsh nor tough or rude. ولن يقبضه الله حتى يقيم به الملة العوجاء. Allah will not take him to him until he straightens up through his call the deviant way. بأن يقول, to declare, لا إله إلا الله, that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah. This is the way of correcting the corrupt creeds. ويفتح الله به قلوبا غلفا, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens through him sealed hearts, وأذانا صمة, and deaf ears, وأعينا عمية, and blind eyes. This is what Abdullah bin Amr involved him in, told Ata as to the description of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Torah. Then Ata said, ثم لقيت كعبا. Afterwards I met Ka'b. Ka'b, he was a Jew originally. فسألته عن ذلك. I asked him about this. فما اختلف حرفا. No single letter was different. This is one example of an authentic Israelite news. As another example, or an example on the weak Israelite, is that which is related from Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, in the explanation of Surah Qaf, in the explanation of chapter 50, that Qaf is a great mountain encompassing this whole world. There's no doubt that this is false, and its relation to Ibn Abbas is a lie. This is the classification of the Israelites in terms of the narration. Then the classification of the Israelites with respect to its agreement with our Sharia. Then it is of three types. Number one, that or the type which is attested to by our Sharia. The type which is attested to by our Sharia. The second is the type which is rejected by our Sharia. And there is a type which is a barrier. In a barrier. Neither accepted nor rejected. And it may be mentioned only as a benefit. As to that which agrees with our Sharia and our Sharia attests to it, is like the narration which came in Sahih Bukhari. This is in Sahih Bukhari, volume 8, number 257. This is the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the planet of earth will be bred on the day of resurrection. and Allah the Irresistible will topple, turn it with his hand, like anyone of you topple, turns a bread with his hands while preparing the bread for a journey. And that bread will be the entertainment for the people of paradise. Then here a man of the Jews, or a man from the Jews, came to the Prophet ﷺ and said, بارك الرحمن عليك يا أبا القاسم. May the beneficent Allah bless you, O Abu al-Qasim. Meaning Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. ألا أخبرك بنزل أهل الجنة يوم القيامة؟ Shall I tell you of the entertainment of the people of paradise on the day of resurrection? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, yes. The Jew said, the earth will be a bread. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم had said. Thereupon the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام looked at us and smiled till his premolar tooth became visible. Then the Jew further said, shall I tell you of the edam, meaning additional food taken from the bread or taken with the bread, that they will have on that they will have with the bread, meaning in paradise? He added, that will be Balam and Noon. Balam, this apparently is a Hebrew word, which means ox. And Noon is an Arabic word which means fish. The people asked, what is that? He said, it is an ox and a fish, and 70,000 people will eat of the codit lob, which is the extra lob of their livers. So in this hadith, this Jew mentioned exactly what the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم informed of. So we didn't accept the words of the Jewish rabbi or the scholar until it was in agreement with our Sharia. This is an example as to that which opposes our Sharia and it is rejected is in the news about Harun, about Aaron alayhi salam. That Harun, Aaron alayhi salam, was the one who made up the calf for the children of Israel, the one they ended up worshipping. We have no doubt whatsoever that this is false, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran that As-Samiri was the one who put together this calf for them. This is in Surah Taha, chapter 20, verse 95 and 96. Chapter 20, 95 and 96. قَالَ فَمَا خَطْبُكَ يَا سَامِرِي قَالَ بَصَرْتُ بِمَا لَمْ يَبْصُرُوا بِهِ فَقَبَضْتُ قَبْضَةً مِنْ أَثَرِ الرَّسُولِ فَنَبَذْتُهَا وكذلك سولت لنفسي. Musa said, and what is the matter with you, O Samiri? Meaning, why did you do that? Samiri said, I saw what they saw not, so I took a handful of dust from the hoof print of the messenger, meaning Jibreel alayhi salam's horse, and threw it into the fire in which were put the ornaments of the Firaun people, or into the calf. Thus my inner self suggested to me. Now, as to the third type, which we refrain from, this refers to the type where we have no agreement in our Sharia concerning it, nor to reject it. This is like the example of the person killed in the story of in the story mentioned in Al-Baqarah, in chapter 2. As to the types of the Israelites with respect to the subject. They are of three types. Some of the Israelites are related to the creed. And from this is the example we gave earlier concerning the Jewish scholar with the Prophet ﷺ and on the Day of Resurrection as to the entertainment of the people in Paradise. And the second type is in the ahkam, in the rulings. For example, in the rulings, take the case of the Jews, the couple who committed adultery. And when the Prophet ﷺ asked the Jew to bring the stoning is a verse that is mentioned in their books, one of the Jews tried to cover that verse in their book, and Abdullah bin Salam knew, and he was a Jew himself, may Allah be pleased with him, he knew that he was trying to cover the verse, so he told him, lift your hand, and the verse was there in the Torah, the verse concerning the stoning. So this is an example on the news from the Israelites pertaining to the rulings and judgments. The third relates to the admonitions and biographies and history. So this is the subject on the term Al-Israeliyat and its relationship to the news which are found in the books of tafsir and hadith, and it goes back to the Jews in general. I found this really an important topic to address in brevity, as you have seen or as you have heard, because it's a matter which is existing in these books, and therefore we have to have we should have an idea about it and what it means and what it entails. And there is a good subject on this written by Sheikh Abdul Aziz Al-Sadhan, Abdul Aziz bin Muhammad Al-Sadhan, may Allah preserve him. For those people who want to expand more on that, and it's also discussed in other books, but this is just a summary of the subject, which I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a benefit for myself and for all of you.